Well, despite the heartbreak for the English players, wonderful to see them still stopping to sign some autographs for the fans. Well, they gave it their all today, did Chris and Gabby Adcock. But that means that Lu Kai and Wang Yashiong safely through to the final. In the top half of the draw, it's the Olympic silver medalist Champeng Soon and Go Liu Ying up against Watanabe and Higashino. That match on court right now, incidentally. So our next match is women's doubles, and it features the bronze medalists from the Rio Olympic Games against the silver medalists from the Olympic Games last year. It's the number three seeds, Jung Kyung Ung and Shin Sung Chan, up against the number two seeds, Christinna Pedersen and Kamilla Rytter. We're looking at the women's doubles draw. You can see that two Korean pairs were in the semi-final stage, and one Korean pair has already booked their place in the final. Number four seeds, Jang Yena and Lee So Hee. So the European champions, not only the Olympic silver medalists, the Danes, but the World Championship silver medalists from the last World Championships, which were in 2015 in Jakarta.
You'll serve, Christina. Shouldn't
you see that side? Thank you. So what a moment for the Danes. And I suppose equally for the Korean pair, because if they were to win, it's an all-Korean final, and that hasn't happened for 23 years. Jung Kyung-un turned 26 9 days ago, and she is from Masan, the coastal city in southeastern Republic of Korea. Her partner is just 22 years of age, and they are currently number three in the world ranking, but as you can see, they have been as high as two. In early November last year, had 3 weeks as world number twos. They've been in four Super Series tournament finals, winning two of them. And this week here in Birmingham, well, it was their second round match, which was the toughest for them, against the left and right handed combination of Vivian Hu and Woon Ki Wei. Dropped the opening game there before coming back 21-17 in the deciding game. That was an hour and 19 minutes. Yesterday, in the quarterfinal against Tanaka and Yonimoto, it was two straight games, and I caught a glimpse of that one, and I thought how well the Koreans were playing yesterday. As far as the Danes are concerned, the number two seeds, that's Christinna Pedersen. 30 years of age now, born in Aalborg in North Jutland. She personally has four World Championship medals and two Olympic medals, because not only her silver medal at the last Olympics in 2012, she was a bronze medalist in the mixed doubles with Joachim Fischer-Nielsen. Kamilla Rytter is attempting today to reach a third All-England final, because she's been in two finals in the mixed doubles with Thomas Laybourne in 2005 and 2012. She was born in Skagen, the 33-year-old. Skagen right in the north of North Jutland. And they have won all of their matches in two straight games, including yesterday's quarterfinal against number eight seeds, the 2015 World Championship bronze medalists Fukuman and Yonau. So they too have been in very good form. And I should mention that Christinna Pedersen has also been in an All-England final. That was last year in the mixed doubles. Now this will be the sixth meeting between these two pairs, and of the previous five, it's the Danes who have won on three occasions, including the last time, which was in the group stage of last year's Dubai Super Series finals. An hour and 9 minutes for those three games. Amanda Ballan from England and Alan Potter, our service judge.
Ladies and gentlemen, on my right, Jung Kyung Un, Shin Sung Chan, Korea. On my left, Kamilla Rytter Juhl, Christinna Pedersen, Denmark.
European champions, three-time European champions, the Danes.
Christinna Pedersen serve to Shin Sung Chan. Another play.
Well, the last European pair to reach the All England final was indeed a Danish pair, but you have to go back 21 years, 1996, Selina Kirkegaard and Rikard Olsen lost in the final to Gerfe and Gu Jun. And the last All England winners of the women's doubles from Europe, Steen?
That's a very, very difficult question. It could be perhaps Nora Perry, Jane Webster.
Fantastic. 1981, 36 years ago. Yeah, well taken. So it's been a long, long wait. Can the Danes today? No. Convert the semi-final into a final.
Two Korean pair left, and they beat both Korean pairs at the Olympics, so I don't see any reason why not.
Yes.
Of course, it's all based on earlier meetings and so on, so you still have to play the matches, and it's not that Jung and Shin will do everything in their power to prevent the Danes from reaching the final.
Service
fault call. Racket not pointing in a downward direction.
Service over. One.
I find that difficult to understand.
One,
let's have a look at this. I'm not sure. I think that was a correct call.
But it starts in a very, very horizontal position, so I don't really blame the service judge, because it really looks like it. That's important that Kamilla Rytter Juhl gets a good start in her rushes from the backcourt towards the net.
Yes, one from the back, then one from half court, and then two from the front to finish it off.
Basic multi-feeding exercise, actually.
So the 2-4.
From Jung Kyung Un. Oh, goodness me. What disguise and what accuracy on that drop shot.
Very well disguised.
Well, I think we might see a number of these long rallies.
Yeah, and it's important for the Koreans to find ways to penetrate the Danish defense in those long rallies.
Read that block.
So,
5-3. And of course, she's a former world mixed doubles champion. So she knows how to finish off a shuttle from the front of the court. Doubles final puts an end to a 9-year wait for a Korean women's doubles pair in the final of the All England.
Since Lee Kyung Won and Lee Hyo Jung.
That's correct. And they won the title in 2008, beating Lee Jung and Lee Yang in the final. Seemed to be massaging that right shoulder. Such a good serve. Yeah, that's a good smash too. For our Kimin. What a mixed doubles and women's doubles player she was.
And women's singles actually also.
Won the Singapore Open. I think as a 17-year-old.
Not the correct play from the Korean side, in my opinion, there. Challenging Kamilla to Juhl in the defense.
What would you do then? What would you advise the Koreans?
I would advise them to move her around. Drop, clear. And then if she's a little late into defensive position, then you can target her, but not when she's standing there waiting for that extremely good defense, in my opinion.
Defense goes just long.
Service over, 5-8.
Absolutely superb from Jung. Look at that.
Okay, thank you. Yeah, I think the Danes expected her to defend with her backhand because Kamilla Review was hovering around at the net, looking for a chance to kill it with her left hand. Very, very clever defense.
The direction of that smash. And towards the left shoulder. Because of course the player on the cross court there is covering the middle, smash down the middle of the court.
Oh,
It was the disguised drop shot from Shin Sung Chan. Did the damage.
8-10.
This one. Yeah, that's a super shot.
Perfectly placed because Christina Pedersen moves a little bit towards it as well.
Longest rally of the match so far.
Play.
Oh, service error. That might be the first of the match. Gives the point to the mid-game interval.
Like this below. Vi står en anden lille god vis. Okay. Vi må gerne på den første, hvis vi kan flytte den også. Eller lige prøve på at lock den første, i hvert fald hvis Shin slår fra baglinjen. Ellers så, når vi ryger ind som netspiller og ryger ud, slå lige et drop. Fordi de styrter tilbage og står og dækker. Eller bare tage farten ud af det
andet. Ja, det snakker vi også om.
At det behøver ikke at være et super drop, men tage farten ud af den lidt. Den døde foran. Det
er sådan, når vi kan mærke, at bolden er blevet lidt tung. Så kan det ikke være power. Nej. Der kan ikke komme af.
Nej. Og så tredje bolden, kun hvis vi er meget ovenpå, så giver vi den fart. Ellers så spiller vi den imellem dem.
Ja.
Imellem. Det er sindssygt godt.
What was Kenny saying there?
Yeah, he was very, very satisfied. They were sort of displaying a really good defense, the Danes, and I totally agree on that. And then there were some instructions when the net player sort of intercepted or had to relieve the backcourt player. Maybe once in a while play a soft shot or a drop shot there instead of using power because he feels the Koreans are standing quite far back.
Very well played. Kim Nielsen, the other Danish coach.
Yes.
Good steep smash there from Christina Pedersen. And look, Kamilla was Juhl, she was following up in the other side.
Yeah. Serve return and third shot, if you can anticipate that third shot. As Juhl did there. It's landed in. Good shot from Jung.
9-13.
And some directions attached to that rally from Ra Kyung Min.
Are
the ones moving the faster of the two pairs. I think maybe the Koreans are feeling a little bit tense.
hesitation. Yeah, they enjoyed that.
Service over. 15-10.
The variation in pace, yeah. That's what you were talking about earlier.
Yeah. Don't, I mean, if you hit on any women's doubles, top women's doubles that are standing ready in their defensive stance, then you have a very little chance of killing it or creating something good unless you're really, really a hard hitter. So you've got to move your opponents, got to have variation, cross smashes, drop shots, clears once in a while. A bit difficult for the Koreans to clear, playing the far side of the court. Excellent by Kamilla Rizul there. We saw again the rushes from the backcourt towards the net, one of her absolutely
16-11.
Strong points.
He's hit straight. Because it's dangerous for opponents to lift cross-court.
Yeah.
And then you can follow forward.
You can play yourself good, so to speak.
Yeah.
Service over. 12-16.
They made a couple of errors on the baseline there, the Danes. That's a little surprising. But apart from that, it's been quite smooth sailing so far. So let's see if they can convert it to a game win.
Oh, what defense. Built the opportunity. Worked so hard for
13,
the opportunity.
16.
She gave that a little bit of topspin.
Yeah.
So it's over.
Trademark return.
17-14.
I'm not sure if I was serving to Kamilla Rytter, whether it's a good idea to serve to the tee when she's in that left-hand court.
You have to target the left shoulder, I think.
Yeah.
Make her choose between forehand and backhand return.
Service over.
The worrying 14, thing for the Danes 17. Here is that, in my opinion, they've played far better than the Koreans, but they're only 3 points ahead.
Yeah.
It's really important for the Danes to convert this to a game win and be 1-0 up. So, very, very important right now.
Well taken.
Yeah. Service over. 18-14.
I think we've seen on a number of occasions that Jung gets a little bit annoyed when she's making mistakes or when shuttles are killed at her. Positive that the Danes have that read.
Yes, good placement of the smash. Across the body towards that right hip.
19-14.
Yeah, you're right. Her body language after that rally as well. Not good. Very thin one. Oh, my goodness, he's gone. Wild. Oh, well, long at that time. I suspect she may have changed her mind there.
And she's a bit high in her stance coming forward to the net, coming over to you. So she's a little bit vulnerable if the return coming back is a flat one.
Game point opportunities. To be precise.
20, game point, 15. So it's over. 16-20.
Opening game, 21-16.
First game
in favour of the Olympic silver medalist against the Olympic bronze medalist. 22 minutes for that opening game. 21-16.
Vigtigt. Afslappet afvikling, hvis vi ikke er i god position. Ingen så meget fart ned på catcheren af dem, som vi gjorde her det sidste. Bare stille og roligt, lad dem skal stå og kreere. Okay. Ja. Når vi så laver, så kan vi bagefter lave temposkift over mod Jung, og så skal vi bare dække ud, for der kommer ikke den korte. Ikke den, hun har lavet den ene kort plus, men hvis vi dækker ud, så snapper vi også den.
Ja.
Ja, lige nok. Eller eventuelt en lille stik ind mod... Når vi saver til Shin, så er bagspilleren klar, og netspilleren Max klar. Når vi saver til Jung, så er netspilleren en lille smule mere opmærksom, bare lige omkring, og bagspilleren er meget på. Okay?
På dem, at vi bliver ved i alle
duellerne.
Ja, lige nøjagtigt.
Og så husk, den her klar.
Ja.
Okay. Hele tiden. Netspiller, hvis den anden aktion dækker ud, så lave den svære kort op sammen.
Ja.
Ja, det er pisse godt.
Fed indstilling.
Very positive coaching situation there for the Danes. Blame them. General reinforcements on what to focus on here in the second game, and then some specifics
second
about
game.
The service situation. The two Korean players.
That's very well taken, isn't it? it's well worked. It's that understanding between the left and the right hander.
Yeah, it's the teamwork, the smash, the correct smash placement from Christinna Pedersen sets it up for Kamilla Rytter, where she's the best.
Yeah.
Forehand side of the net.
Too shabby on the backhand, clearly.
No. It's really good. I mean, in my opinion, the Danes have been totally dominant in this first game. The Koreans have had nothing except for a sort of small chances here and there, but nothing really worrying that you can say we've got to take care of this and beware of that. Writing a book at the moment, Kamilla Rytter and Christinna Pedersen, and they've got their co-writer here at the tournament. It'll be released in both Danish and English. Rally from a Korean perspective, because they were able to penetrate the Danish defense, but they made to work hard.
Come chat, play.
Frustration.
Yeah, I think Korea could, use an All England title after having said goodbye to four of the best men's doubles players in the world and one of the best mixed doubles as well in Ko Sung Hyun and Kim Han Ah. Kim Han Ah still playing, but out of this tournament. Now lost in the quarterfinal with Yo Yong Song. So, need some good results, the Korean team.
Oh, that's well taken.
Set is over. 5-5.
Yes, the last time they won a title here was 2012, wasn't it? In the doubles. Kim Jae Sung and Lee Yong Dae. Oh, well left. I thought she was going to play that.
Yeah.
6-5.
Six shots in the opening game, didn't we?
Yeah.
But when you're consistently playing 20, 30 shot rallies, the physicality of the match becomes a crucial factor.
Yeah.
I think that's one of the areas where the Danes have improved, become more fit, not afraid anymore of playing the long rallies.
Christinna Pedersen in this rally. Yeah.
7-8.
Oh, Kyung enjoyed that one.
Yes.
Winner of 6 All England titles herself, the coach. 5 mixed doubles and 1 women's doubles.
The Kyung won as well?
Christine.
Women's doubles?
I can't remember, I'll check it for you.
7-8.
Kyung Jae-hee.
Unbelievable!
did that one come from?
I think it's from tennis practice this summer.
9-7.
Looked to be in dire trouble.
Sunshine, play.
To the mid-game interval.
Seven, interval.
They have a four-point advantage. They only had a three-point advantage in the opening game.
Det er så vigtigt, at vi kommer igennem den her hårde fase. Bare blive ved derinde. Hvis det bliver rigtig hårdt, så er det fordi, I har slået for mange gange for hårdt i streg. Ikke? Det må vi gerne, hvis vi bryder den, og så stempler ud begge sider, og så står vi bare side om side og dækker meget bagud. Okay?
Ja.
En enkelt gang fra dig, hvis netop at Shin, eller undskyld, Jung, hun står lige for dig over for din overhånd. Så uden fart, eller ned i midten.
Ja, generelt skal jeg ikke slå så meget hårdt.
Nej, ikke på den første. Bare med armen, stille og roligt. Oh, oh, oh.
So the advice there, Steen?
First of all, something about managing the long rallies and sort of enduring them. I think perhaps even they could enjoy them today because they're winning a lot of them. And then again, take the pace out of some of the shots. No harm in doing that. Put it below the tape. When they do that, they have to sort of change the cover so they don't cover front court, back court, but cover mid court, both of them.
12.
I think they need to target Jung as well. I think she's going through a bit of a bad patch at the moment.
Yeah, she has not had a... Look at this odd stance there. Her feet are pointing towards the long corner in the right side of the court. It's a very, very odd stance.
Oh, my goodness me. Excellent read from Kamilla Juhl.
13-7.
She has appearance here somewhere between the Danish spectators. They've been regulars here at All England, I think, ever since she reached her first final in 2005.
Oh no, it's called out. They're challenging.
Kamilla, Rytter, Juhl, challenges called out.
Oh, it's obvious my initial reaction that it had landed in. Now I was surprised by the line call. Let's see what Hawkeye say. Oh no. Line judge was right.
Challenge unsuccessful. One challenge remaining. Service over. 8-13. Play.
Thank you.
They're playing with so great discipline and technical awareness, the two Danes.
Service over, 14-8.
I think she's played herself out of her bad patch. She's now looking much better again.
14. The problem is that you probably can't have that bad a patch and still survive in the semi-final of the All England. They got to make a run for it now,
10,
I think.
14.
The Koreans still 4 points down.
With that.
Yes. And the reaction sort of indicates that this is something that they've discussed and watched during video sessions ahead of this match. They're so dominant right now, the Danes. I must admit, I can't really see how the Koreans are going to get back into this match, unless they get a little bit tensed, Danish side, on the prospect of entering the All England final.
Superb today.
And of course they know by now that if they win this match they're going to meet another Korean pair in the final, so it's also about sort of displaying an attitude and say, hey, if you want to win this you got to get past us, and that's not going to be easy.
Yeah.
Against the mighty Giffey and Gujun,
yeah,
who were ruling women's doubles at that time. Mickey Olsen, actually now a coach with the Danish youth team.
Oh my goodness, she put that away with venom.
Let's go! Let's go! Let's go!
went down so crisply.
They played some good matches, both during the World Championships in Jakarta, but also during the Olympics. This is one of the absolute best matches I've seen them play.
Challenge here from the Koreans.
I think it has the part of the line.
Called in.
It's their first challenge of the whole match. Out.
Yeah.
Good challenge.
Correction, out. So this over 12-18 play.
Away.
19-12.
And a place in the All England final.
They haven't dropped the game yet in this tournament.
No, they haven't. And this is only just the longest match. 46 minutes as match points come up. The Danish fans are on their feet.
Match points.
Yeah, there's Kamilla's father just in front of the Danish flag.
Stretching out her back, Jung.
Service over. 13-20. Christinna Pedersen and Kamilla Rytter will contest the final tomorrow. What a convincing semi-final, 21-16, 21-13. Called by Kamilla Rytter, Christinna Pedersen, 21-16, 21-13.
Well, the traditional celebration with their fans. Yes, they embrace family.
Yeah, that's Christina's parents. And there's Camilla's father and her mother in the white shirt there.
Oh, what a wonderful moment.
And the astonishing thing is that this double was actually created as a byproduct to sort of keep them in shape for the mixed.
Oh, astonishing. We mustn't go overboard with the celebrations. There's another match tomorrow. Well, the World Championship silver medalists, the Olympic silver medalists, will have an opportunity to become the All England champions. 21-16, 21-30 in a match lasting 47 minutes. Yeah. Enjoy the moments, and why not? A first All England final for either of them tomorrow. They've both been in mixed doubles finals. But first time that they've been in a women's doubles final. Well, an opportunity for them to lift the All England crown tomorrow. What an occasion for the Danes, because Kamilla, Juhl and Christinna Pedersen, the number two seeds, will contest the final tomorrow against the number four seeds. And Lee. So just one more semi-final to come, and it's men's doubles, and it involves Danes once again, and once again European champions. As with the women's doubles, the men's doubles pair, current European champions, Mats Konrad Pedersen and Mats Kolding, up against the number five seeds, Gideon and Sukumoglio. As far as the men's doubles draw is concerned, three different nations by semi-final stage, an all Chinese affair in the top half of the draw, and it's been won by the number six seeds, Li Junhui and Yu Chen. So there, Kevin Sanjaya Sukumoglio. And what an exciting, fast player he is. He and his partner, Marcus Fernaldi.